That's right. We're on live. We're going to get this thing done one way or another. What's up to y'all?
Since I was little, my mom was always incredibly put together and fashion forward and very artsy in her presentation. So that rubbed off on me at a very early age. After my mom passed away, my aunt, who'd worked in fashion for many, many years, really took me under her wing and showed me what works and what doesn't work and why things work. She was wonderful about telling me what colors went together, what patterns went together, how to start developing your own sense of style. If you're watching Auntie Sharon, thank you. Fashion and design are very visual arts, typically. It depends a lot on pattern and color and cut. But I would argue that for me, fashion is about feeling and emotion and texture. Sure, I love color and I love evoking certain emotions with color and I know what colors work well for me, but it's less important than the textures and the patterns and the layers that I create using the clothing that I have. One of the things that really helped me get into design and understanding clothes and what fits well and what doesn't was when I started sewing. Really taking apart clothing and understanding how it's constructed goes a long way into understanding what works for different body types, what shapes feel nice, what type of construction feels best on your body. It gave me a real chance to start exploring new things that I hadn't had the opportunity to do before, because it's very easy to get stuck in certain styles and not go outside your comfort zone. If I had to describe my style, I would say it would be a smart, sophisticated, possibly business casual, with a little bit of a retro or vintage flair. For me, it's all about the silhouette. What silhouette are you creating? So I will typically mix vintage pieces and very modern pieces together to create something entirely new. For example, the neckline on this dark green blouse that I'm wearing has a very Victorian feel because it's got a cameo right at the center of the collar. It's got a very high-necked collar, but satin wasn't a fabric that was used very often in Victorian, so it's got that little modern twist. Again, I'll show you when I stand up. I'm wearing leatherette pants with very tall buttons, which is a very modern fit, but I'm mixing it together with this very vintage flair. When I was really interested in developing my own style outside of the people that were in my immediate circle, I turned to YouTube. A lot of my knowledge about vintage fashion and vintage wear came from research I did myself when I started constructing a lot of costumes, but also from creators like Jessica Kellgren Fozard, who is not only a disability advocate and a queen in the disability community, but a fashionista who loves 1950s vintage style. I also watch creators like Karina Wang and Carly Christman, who really go into depth into what's hot and what's not in any given season. They do lookbooks and lots of different outfits explaining what goes well together. So I use those as inspiration. I wish that creators like that would go into more detail about cut and color and describing the fabrics, but I know that that's not necessarily what everybody else wants. It's just what I need. I may not be able to walk through a mall and see what the trends are on the mannequins. I have to get that information a different way. So I use a lot of different resources to understand what colors work, what are the cuts this season, and then I try and incorporate one or two new pieces so I can feel up to date while still using what feels comfortable for me. I don't believe that fashion should have to cost a fortune. I try to recycle, reuse, upcycle, buy things secondhand so that I don't need to contribute to the high fashion waste. Do I occasionally buy fast fashion? Yes, but I'm trying to cut down on that. So let me take you on a tour of my closet and we'll talk about not only how I keep it organized, but how I find the pieces that I really like and what textures and patterns I really enjoy putting together. Welcome to my closet. When I moved into this space, I had a real opportunity to do something that really worked for me. I built myself a PAX wardrobe, but that was simply because I didn't have a space for clothes in my bedroom. So what I ended up doing is I organized it by type. So I could have my short hang tops and my blouses and my jackets here, my pants at the bottom. I could keep my accessories like my corsets and my scarves and my other pieces that I needed for a lot of the things that I don't use as often up high. I could keep everything in my long hang organized. I could have spaces for all of my undergarments and my sunglasses and my shoes and my purses. So everything had a home. And when I tell you that my closet looks exactly like this all the time, it does. When everything has a home, I can be independent. Because I know every single piece in this closet. I know exactly what color it is, I know exactly what goes with it, and I've taken the time to know my space. I have everything in this closet organized from light to dark. So I have my white blouses and white tops, and that moves into creams and pinks, and then from pinks to burgundies, then burgundies to reds, then greens, then blues, then grays, then blacks. Same thing goes with my pants. They're hung double because I often have two of each type of pant. So I have two pairs of jeans, two pairs of black jeans, two pairs of interesting colors, two pairs of leggings, and each one of those has a spot in this closet. The one on top is the brown one because I wear it more often, and the one underneath is the khaki green one, which I wear less often. So if I wear it more, it goes on top. You'll probably notice along the top of my closet here, I have a lot of hats in a lot of different colors. Hats are a necessity for me as a person with albinism and as a person who suffers from photophobia. Lights are incredibly painful and I can burn my scalp in under 5 minutes. So to make hats work as part of my fashion, I almost had to dive into vintage fashion a little bit to make that work. Because if I wanted to wear a nice blouse and a ball cap, those don't tend to go together as well as if I'm wearing something that's got a little bit of a vintage flair to it, and then I put on a 1950s, 1960s style bucket hat, it's gonna look a little more put together than if I stuck on a ball cap instead. It's obvious, I love shoes. I have a lot of different colors, but of course I spent most of my time looking for pairs that were in blacks, grays, and whites, because that's what goes with most of my wardrobe. I tend to stick in the neutrals and avoid lots of bright colors like reds, greens, and pinks because they're a lot more challenging to match with other items. Again, here, I'm not a very big purse person, but I have a few for formal occasions or if I need to go out for the day, and I thought it was really nice to keep them on display when they're not being used. When we get into my long hang, this is where things get a little bit weird because I've organized it differently than the other sections in my closet. I have white, then black, then my colors. But that's because I'm always reaching for my whites and my darks first. And then if I need to find something in my colored areas, I go there last, and then I just have my house coats over here on the side. So when I think about buying something, I think about what really stands out against my skin tone. And depending on what color skin you have, certain colors may look better than others. For me, because I am so pale, white is generally something that I avoid. I do have some whites, but I always pair it with color, because otherwise that washes me out. Again, I typically avoid pastels for the same reason. So when I go looking for clothes, I go into the bright tones, maybe not electric, I do have some of that, but the gem tones are typically what stands out really well against my skin. Let me pull something from my closet and I'll put together an outfit so I can show you how I pair things. This piece right here is one of my favorites. It is an electric blue blazer. When you have bright colors, I typically like to put it together with more muted tones. So with this one, we could do a monochromatic look where I pin the electric blue with a navy blue top and some navy pants. Or what I'd more likely do, because I want even more contrast, is I would probably pin this with a black and then an exciting pant. Probably the pants that I'm wearing right now, because they've got silver buttons and they go with both of these looks and elevate it a little bit so it looks a little more fashion forward. I'm gonna have Robbie off camera pick something out of my wardrobe, anything at all, and I'm gonna try and build an outfit around what he chooses. So he gave me a real doozy. This is a lace shawl with fringe at the bottom. Because this is something that is relatively new to my wardrobe, my sister actually gave it to me a couple of weeks ago, I don't actually have anything set that I would pair with it. So this is gonna be a real challenge. Because this has a lot of texture with the lace up top, and it feels very summery, I would probably put this together as more of a summer look. I would find something that's generally a solid color to go underneath this lace, and then I would probably pair this with a medium to dark wash denim. So now let's explore and see what we'd put together as a top. I had a flip through a lot of things I own, and I think what I'd pair with this black shawl is actually this white top. Just because it's going to show off the lace more than any other color. I could go with a black to really tone down the black lace shawl, but I think I want to show it off. So I would pair this together, and then this would either make a cute shopping outfit, something I could wear to work, or something that you could wear on a casual Friday, depending on which pant you'd pair with it. So this would work with a pair of sneakers or with a pair of high heels. And I like doing things that are gonna create versatility that you can mix and match with a lot of different items so that you can create 1,000 different things in your wardrobe. Maybe I don't have quite a capsule wardrobe, but I do like to have multiple functions for each piece. So this is my outfit. Let me know what you think. Jeans, black lace shawl, white flowy top. Thank you so much for watching. I know I approach fashion from a really unique perspective, so I hope it gave you something to try, something new to explore when it comes to fashion that you may not have thought about before.